And then our first item has to do with the Drury Master Plan. Mr. Burris.
Thank you. So Drury University recently did some master planning, and we invited David Hinson, who's a vice president at Drury, to come to our leadership team meeting and show the presentation. He's going to do an abbreviated version of that presentation for you here today. It was a very impressive presentation, and I think the planning that Drury University is doing is be a great asset for our community for many years. And so with that, I'm going to turn it over to David and let him take it from here.
Welcome, sir.
Well, thank you for having us today. We're certainly appreciative to be here with the city, the mayor, and the council. Pursuant to our guest and Greg's mention of prerequisite for employment, I would make mention that Drury does have openings in the Law Enforcement Academy. So, although I'm here to talk about the master plan today. We've got about 90 slides. Obviously, we will not go through 90 slides today. Let me just make mention that the city has been extremely supportive in our efforts and has been opening and welcoming to us as we have discussed our dreams and our plan and our vision for this master plan. We recognize that Drury doesn't sit in isolation. We are very much engaged and connected to our neighbors, Springfield Public Schools, the city, the utility districts, Midtown neighborhood. We want to make sure that we are transparent and open as we move forward in this process and make sure that we engage the appropriate neighbors at the appropriate time. By way of history, we were commissioned by our Board of Trustees in October of 2016 to start engaging a master planning process, and we went about doing that by hiring some partners who would help us identify leading master planners from across the United States and overseas. We invited 10 master planners to come to a pre-proposal conference to talk to us about what we hope to accomplish with our master plan. Out of those 10, we had 7 ultimately that came here to Springfield, visited the city, heard us for a half a day, walked the campus. Ultimately, we had 6 that put in proposals, and at the end of the day, we wound up selecting Cooper Robertson from New York City. They were highly engaged, they presented a plan that fit well within our vision, and they put forward some ideas that we felt like that we could accomplish to achieve our goals with the master plan. And you may have heard Dr. Cloyd, our president, talk about make no little plans, they have no magic to stir people's blood. Our hope with this master plan is to not only put forward a vision, but to connect that vision to our leadership, our donors, our friends and family, to make sure that we can make this plan a real thing. So why a master plan? Well, a goal without a plan is simply a wish. And we went about a 3-phase process to engage this plan. First was a discovery phase, and we invited about 18 different constituencies during a week-long charrette to come to campus. A charrette is a very intensive face-to-face design session. So poor John Kirk, the principal from Cooper Robertson, had to repeat the same spiel 18 different times to these different constituencies. But ultimately, it came down to this. We asked each constituency, what does Drury University mean to you? What does it mean when you hear the word Drury? And so we encapsulated all of that feedback into a number of key recognitions. We kept hearing over and over and over again about how we were landlocked, about how we unravel at the edges. If you're a newcomer to Springfield, if you try to find Drury, if you come across the bridge on Chestnut, you might see a little green sign that says Drury University. If you go past it, all you see is Mountain Ozark popcorn. So we want to make sure that we better define our boundaries. The presupposition that we're landlocked, we actually sit on 100 acres. And so we began to realize that really what we needed to do is to reimagine our sense of density and what we could put on our property. We're not simply one campus, we're 3 campuses. We have a northern precinct where we have residential and fraternities. We have a middle academic core, and then we have our professional schools on the southern end abutting Chestnut Expressway. Connectivity to our context is essential. Like I said, we don't exist in isolation. We're deeply connected to Midtown, and so we have some challenges. It's relatively easy to get north-south on our campus. Once you get on the Drury Lane, it's easy to navigate that, but moving from east to west is a bit of a challenge. We recognize that our neighbors should be our partners, and that we've got a number of very iconic buildings on campus that can be the keystones of what we want to do moving forward. So what will guide the master plan? Well, you have to kind of know where you're going in order to make sure that you get there. And so with that, we developed a number of different guiding principles. We first and foremost want to preserve what makes Drury, Drury. We want to enhance the campus as it exists today. Better walkways, intimate exterior spaces. We want to strengthen our edges with hardscape landscape. We want to establish a hierarchy of thresholds or a number of different front doors. We like to think not simply of boundaries to campus, but thresholds. Once you cross that threshold, you know you're on the Drury. You will notice by the hardscape and landscape that you've arrived at our place. We want to reimagine Drury Lane as a very beautiful pedestrian walkway. Currently, it's one of the more iconic features of our campus. Unfortunately, as it exists today, it's a driveway. So we want to change that into something much more beautiful, a promenade, if you will. We want to establish these intimate quad spaces to the north of campus, to the south of campus. As we imagine these new buildings that will go onto campus, we want to create these intimate exterior, interior spaces. We want to strengthen our perimeter through joint venture partnerships. So here we're looking at Central and Benton. We are imagining that there may be some joint partnerships here on the extreme southern end of campus. We want to establish better connections, not only with downtown, but also with Commercial Street to our north. There are a number of geographic challenges to that. You have Division Street to the north of campus and a bit of a walk. You've got Chestnut Expressway, which is obviously a pretty substantial physical barrier. We need to better understand how we can overcome those barriers. And we want to welcome and establish a welcoming presence to those on campus. We want to make sure that it's beautiful and welcoming to our guests. We are currently challenged by having our athletics far afield. If you want to go see baseball, Drury baseball, you have to go to Nixa. And so that involves students getting into cars, going to practice, playing games. We feel like we would better inculcate a sense of campus team spirit by having everyone on campus. And so to do that, we have to have a place to aggregate those athletic facilities. Not only playing fields, but also field houses and dressing rooms. And we want to address the lands east of Drury to the railroad and Ozark Technical College, not necessarily to establish a boundary, but to determine how we may best create thresholds so that you can know when you arrive onto the campus at Drury University. We want to articulate a coherent, legible, and memorable architectural expression. That is to say, we don't necessarily want every building to look the same, but we definitely want a Drury look in how we approach our buildings. So, we're looking at red brick and limestone and a certain sense of style and continuity that when you look at one of our new buildings, you will understand that it's a part of the Drury campus. So what are our options? Well, the options phase of this, once we got through discovery, was to say, okay, we've got all these different ideas and concepts and guiding principles. What do we do next? And you first have to look at what happens if you put specific elements in one place on campus. It then dictates what happens elsewhere. So we looked to the north, we looked to the middle, and we looked to the south, and we understood that we had different options that we could put into play. And understanding what impact, and putting one piece of the puzzle in the north end of campus, helped determine what decisions we made later. So our aspirations are to establish an ordered, memorable, yet flexible framework plan for the university, which will guide all future planning and development. And this is the beginning of our framework plan, where we started to articulate where these different elements were going to occur. We want to articulate each major intersection as a node with hardscape, landscape, and wayfinding. So as I mentioned, we have trouble for newcomers coming to campus understanding how to get where we are. So we feel like if we do a better job of articulating these nodes, these intersections, as roundabouts or better landscaped entrances to the university with a little bit of architecture, maybe it's a folly of sorts, that helps say, here you are at Drury University. And those would appear at key intersections. So at Calhoun and Benton, Benton and Central, Drury Lane and Central, Summit and Calhoun. These are areas that we feel like can better introduce folks and visitors to our campus. We want to better define our edge conditions and create psychological thresholds, not only from the standpoint of arrival, but also to articulate some safety. We tend to think about our campus not as a citadel, but as a city. We want us to be welcoming and opening, and so we have to make sure that if we're not walling people off, we definitely want to make sure that we articulate when it is that you do arrive at Drury University. Again, we want to transform Drury Lane into the iconic heart of campus. And that will involve some landscaping, some hardscape, cutting it off to traffic above Bay Hall here in the lower one quarter of the pie. This would be drivable so that we could get emergency vehicles through there, maybe with some removable barriers. You'll also notice the plan here as you see it. We've made better use of crossways so that our east-west traffic is better navigable. We call those ribs of our campus. We want to make great streets. This is where partnership with the city is essential. Tim and his crew have been great to us as we've shared our vision. They've been instrumental in helping us understand how to plug into the Central Street Corridor project and what the funding cycle and the design cycle of that. We've been engaged with those guys. We presented also to Tim and Mary from zoning. So we understand that we want to create these great streets, and we can only do so in partnership with the city. And we feel like that we've come up with some concepts that speak to what we think the complete street concepts of the city is intending to do, and we fully embrace that. And we feel like we've come together with some good ideas to help that emerge in reality. And finally, we want to establish a hierarchy of open spaces ranging from the iconic to the intimate. So that's where we create these northern quads on campus, where we create these small spaces to create moments. We're not looking to simply say, this building goes here, this building goes there. We're looking at how we can make real the academic program on campus and make Drury a place. So in the interest of showing you guys the sizzle and not necessarily just steak, I'm going to skip ahead and show you the flyover video, and then we can talk about the different elements of the plan.
Thank you.
I'm just going to stop this because this is a great point for us to look at some key elements of what we're really going to focus on. We've got three big initiatives that we're looking at for the master plan. One is a new student life center that will be in the middle of campus. It will abut the Olin Library at the top third of Drury Lane and will create this quad to the north of campus with a redesigned Wallace Hall that will have an archway that will lead north onto Washington Street. So this is a way that we can architecturally better connect ourselves to the Midtown Network neighborhood. Currently, Wallace terminates Drury Lane. We want Drury Lane to continue on as a walkway through the archway and a new tower feature here. The second element that we want to concentrate on is this big complex down here on the corner of Central and Drury Lane. That's our new Design Enterprise Solutions Center that will house the new Drury School of Business. It will also have our comprehensive advising. We'll have a number of different maker spaces in that as far as other collaborative spaces go. It can be built in sections of 40,000 square feet, each section up to a total maximum about 120,000 square feet. And then the reimagined Drury Lane as a pedestrian promenade through the heart of campus. Something that we've been talking to the city and zoning on is a reimagining of Central Street. Currently, it definitively bifurcates campus now. It's a big divider. We hope to beautify it with medians and planting and some hardscape to make it more inviting and create a linear park that celebrates the history of Springfield. At the corner of Benton and Central is the Benton Avenue AME Church, which was the last church that Oliver Brown of the Brown versus the Board of Education was stationed at when he passed away. So it's a place of some significance, and we want to honor that. And so this linear park that we envision will celebrate that with a museum component and some byways and stopways along Central to celebrate our history and how we have contributed to the American ideal. I will make mention that all the materials, the presentation, the flyover animation, and our framework plan, I'm leaving with Tom, and so you guys are free to ask him for copies of that. There's nothing proprietary in that. It's nothing that we haven't shared with the group. And in the interest of time, I think I'll cut off the formal part of the presentation here. I'm happy to field any questions with you guys.
David, thank you. Very, very informative, very exciting. What questions do you have?
I might just say this is really exciting, and I can tell you put a lot of work into this. I assume we're working together. Obviously, there's a Central Street corridor plan. I assume our organizations are working together to make sure that our visions are collaborative and right. Work together well?
Very much so. Tim and his group have been great at inviting us to it, and as we were working through it, I know that they were anxious to see what we were working on as well as we were anxious to be able to get together and work with them. We're currently in a design phase, and so they're working with CJ Nguyen, who is the design team working on that aspect of it. We've shared our concepts with them, and we won't be able to actually do construction until another round of funding comes about. So we are, I think, well engaged at this point to the extent that we can be. Tim, did you want to speak additionally to that or no?
Yeah, we've had some great meetings talking through concepts and had really a fairly similar vision for what Central Street can be. They've been it's been a good discussion. So looking forward to continuing that and finding ways to make Central Street, both a great transportation corridor for all users and an amenity to the Drury campus.
Yeah. So we're dealing not only with the aesthetics, which we obviously are interested in, but how it informs the surrounding context and how do we get snow plows through and how do we get emergency vehicles through. So it's a far-ranging conversation, a lot of moving pieces to it, but it's why you start 24 months out through the design, because there's so much to consider.
Thanks.
Yeah.
I like the trees.
Yeah.
In terms of the money, I always go back to that. So I take it, the streets that we would want city involvement, and I don't know, do you have a capital campaign that goes along for your buildings?
Or
the city, is that, are we just involved as far as the streets, or how does that go in your
I think every decision we make affects you guys in some way or fashion. I know that I talked to Eric Clausen quite honestly a lot about crosswalks. And so different aspects of the life of the city touch us at different points. And so we will have to engage you guys, not simply from funding on things like Central Street Corridor, but we may want to change our parking loads, for example. So part of what we're looking at is along Benton, rather than having currently parallel parking as exists today, we may want to consider diagonal parking, because we feel like we can increase our parking load, which will allow us to move some of these interior parking spaces that occupy a very valuable piece of interior real estate to the edges of campus and not significantly impact or impair traffic that is currently going up and down Benton. So those are ways that we'll have to engage with the city to see, does this make sense? Can we do it? Or is it cost effective? And so, you know, we just can't make a decision to say we're going to put brick pavers, you know, here on a city street. Or
so in terms of funding, it's all just transportation related, the streets?
I think so. Okay. So we're not looking to add burden to anybody with something that's just pie in the sky or something that doesn't fit in with our existing context. We want to make sure that we do things that are reasonable or to plug into funding mechanisms that are in place, like for the design of Central Street. Or as we start to investigate what we're doing with Central, there may be some federal grant money that we can get there because of the historical register and the Benton Avenue AME. So there may be a number of different avenues we look at, as well as there may be some private investment. If you look along Central right in front of the O'Reilly Family Entertainment Center, that's actually mixed use, where we may have a live above unit above a commercial strip that may be there. So there may be a number of different ways that we fund this. So we're not looking at the city simply to help us bootstrap.
Would you go over again about Finley Student Center? Mm-hmm. Are you replacing it, or what will happen in that area?
Yes. The area to the north of campus, we will be replacing the Finley Student Center with a new Student Life Center, and it will move south. Where the Finley Student Center is now, we're envisioning moving about 8 different small houses that will house about 30 students each. We are looking to re-aggregate student life back to the heart of campus. That was something that we felt was a byproduct of past decisions, where we moved and we kind of extended ourselves to the north. And what we were finding were students were getting in their cars to drive to go eat, and we didn't want that. We wanted student life to remain on campus. We wanted the life of campus to remain vibrant after hours. And so by moving housing back to the heart of campus here in the Northern Quad, in the place where Finley is, we feel like we accomplished that. Finley was built sometime in the 70s, and it's not necessarily our number one stop when we take students there, and we recognize that as a competitive advantage and just the quality of life of our students, it's time to make that upgrade.
We do a lot of, I have a transportation company, and our buses do a lot of pickup at Finley Student Center.
Right.
So wherever that would be, keep in mind adequate bus access,
sure.
Please.
Absolutely.
And not through parking lots.
Okay.
because right now it works perfectly whenever we can get there, easily turn around. But
right.
Consider, you know, of course, also buses, motor coaches too. Just
we'll
a little
tidbit.
I just am curious. The Drury Gallery on Commercial Street is a vital part of what happens on Commercial Street, and
right.
That's still part of the master plan to be a presence on Commercial Street.
Yeah, it's a continuing presence for us. We have classes there. We open the gallery 6 days a week. We have some looms, weaving looms are there. So it's essential that we keep that. And the thing to keep in mind, this is a 25-year plan. And so we take a number of different things into consideration. We want to be sensitive to our neighbors and in the neighborhood for Midtown. If you look at this plan, we're really looking to fill in the 100 acres we currently sit on. So you don't see us encroaching into Midtown. But what you might see happening is Drury going into a partnership with maybe a something akin to a Bear Village, but it's something similar to that, where you have a commercial stepping stone going to Commercial Street. Because if you walk from Drury to Commercial now, it's not exactly the most comfortable of walks, just because there aren't a lot of destinations there. So you may see us begin to create some destination points and partnerships in terms of housing, mixed use, commercial, that make that a better connection to Commercial Street.
Thank you.
Mm-hmm.
Well, I just
just to echo on some of what you said, I was impressed with Cooper Robertson, the consulting firm. I was on that task force, and how they envisioned Drury as a part of the whole community, and tying in downtown to Commercial Street as a whole corridor. I know that the city's master plan kind of does that, maybe utilizing Boonville and Drury's idea. It incorporates that whole master plan, and I will say the Board of Trustees has really heartily affirmed this idea, and in such a manner that they're willing to, the board's going to start the fundraising campaign very soon. Yes. And already has some commitments for it, and I think the trustees are very excited about the whole thing.
Yes, sir.
Are you planning for multi-level parking?
If you look here in the front of campus, where you see these two brick pylons here, that's actually parking to grade. So there is parking below that and parking above that. So you can't simply remove parking and expect it to go into the neighborhood. So we are making accommodations of that. Not as visible here, but you'll notice here in the Design Enterprise Solutions Center, we've made room for interior parking. And similarly, on the corner of Benton and Central, that new, we're calling it our Life Sciences Center, there's interior parking there. So,
and what's the long-term use of the rail line? Is that?
We're assuming it's going to be there until that spur is vacated, which, as I understand, you know, may be next year, it may be 200 years from now, depending upon the use. But we're depending on there. Now, what we will try to do is to beautify the grade and better tie in our edges of campus there with some landscaping. But we anticipate that it will continue to be there.
David, thank you so much.
Thank you very much.
Excellent presentation. We're excited. Certainly, Drury is a key community partner. Right. We just want to be an asset to you.
Thank you very much. Thank you very much for your time.
Aaron, thank you.
Thank you.